Hello, I am Dr. Jasleen Arora, consultant neonatologist and pediatrician at Amandeep Medicity Hospital, Amritsar. Today we are organizing World Breastfeeding Day to create awareness about the breastfeeding. Breastfeeding is feeding of direct breast milk to the baby or express breast milk to the babies. I just want to tell everyone that breast milk is the first immunization of your baby. The first water milk that comes in the first 48 to 72 hours of the delivery is called colostrum. It's rich in lots of antibodies, rich in IgA and secretory antibodies which help increase the immune level of the babies. It goes long term in protection of the baby from asthma, chronic diarrhea, allergic reactions, and in long run it also helps in protecting the baby from coronary artery disease, hypertension and diabetes mellitus. So breastfeeding is very important for your baby and it's the best gift a mother can give to a baby. The breast milk after 3-4 days turns thicker and is whiter, and as we know it has a milk-like consistency. This milk comes in two parts, foremilk and hindmilk. The foremilk quenches the thirst of the baby as it is more rich in water. The hindmilk, as it is rich in fat, proteins and carbohydrates, makes the baby's tummy full and helps to satiate them and increase in the weight gain. So if you're frequently switching your breasts while feeding, the baby may just get foremilk and your baby may not gain adequate weight. So while breastfeeding, make sure that you empty your breast fully from one side before switching to the other side. A breastfed baby will pass urine almost 6 to 8 times in 24 hours and may pass stools every once in a week or maybe 8 to 10 times per day. The stool is liquid in consistency with watery with grains, yellow grains mixed in it. That is absolutely normal for your baby. And if your baby poops after taking feed, after every feed, that is also normal because it's because of the gastrocolic reflex in your babies, which is very active and it subsides by the time baby grows, and it's like 3 to 4 months. Your baby will be able to hold more milk and pass stools at longer intervals. Other than that, most parents ask till when to continue breastfeeding. The exclusive breastfeeding is to be continued till 6 months of age. That means no water, no honey or no other substitute milk should be given to the baby till your baby is 6 months old. After that, we don't stop breastfeeding. We just complement breastfeeding with other solid, semi-solid diets like your homemade cooked food which is culturally acceptable, like suji ki kheer, dalia, your sabudana kheer, aapki besan ki kheer, aap namkeen suji ka chila bana sakte hain, namkeen suji. All these things can be incorporated in a baby's diet, and as the baby grows older you can increase its consistency and make sure that it is more granular and the baby is exposed to more taste and texture. Other than that, most working mothers have a question that since I'm supposed to rejoin my duty maybe in 4 months or maybe 6 months, how should I breastfeed my baby? Since I cannot breastfeed, I'd have to introduce water. So mothers, let me tell you this. Yes, you have to join the duty, it is important. But you can continue breastfeeding your baby indirectly. How? Just express your milk, and that express milk can be fed to your baby in your absence. That you can feed either by cutoria or spoon or bottle feed as you feel it is comfortable. Most babies will accept the bottle and there will be no risk like ki baby baad mein bottle nahi pakdega ya baby ko pata nahi chalega bottle kaise leni hai. First 40 days of puerperium, jise hum kehte hain chaliya kaatna, are very important to make sure that the baby is comfortable on the breast and to ensure that you have adequate breast milk productions. If you introduce mixed feed during that time or introduce bottle during that time, the breastfeeding won't be established. There will be no bond between the baby and the mother. And so, make sure that you're breastfeeding your baby as much as possible, as long as possible, as long as your baby desires, maybe up to 2 years, or some mothers may breastfeed up to 3 years also if they are comfortable. But make sure that you have introduced adequate complementary feed in the baby's diet. Other than that, there are lots of benefits for the mothers also who breastfeed their babies. The most important one of them is it increases mother and child bonding. जब एक मदर अपने बेबी को होल्ड करती है या ब्रेस्ट के साथ फीड कराती है तो एक अलग ही नूर जिसे हम कहते हैं मदर के फेस पे आता है. द बेबीज रिकॉग्नाइज द टच ऑफ देयर मदर, बेबीज रिकॉग्नाइज द स्मेल ऑफ देयर मदर्स, एंड देयर इज इंक्रीज मदर चाइल्ड बॉन्डिंग. अदर देन दैट, मदर्स के लिए बेनिफिट है कि इट इंक्रीजेज द रिस्क ऑफ पोस्टपार्टम डिप्रेशन एंड पोस्टपार्टम ब्लीडिंग ऑल्सो. द यूट्रस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फास्टर एंड द मदर्स uterus size returns to the pre-pregnancy stage faster. It protects the mothers from the risk of ovarian cancer and breast cancers. And other than that, it has lots of economic benefits, since you don't have to buy a powder milk formula for your baby, you don't have to sterilize your bottles, you don't have to buy the bottles also. So it is cheaper, economic, and less time consuming also. So all this is a message on this breastfeeding week to all my mothers. Please make sure that you breastfeed your baby exclusively for at least 6 months and for as long as possible. This is not a choice. It's your responsibility that your baby gets this breast milk, because that's the best way, gift that you can give your baby. Thank you so much, dear mothers. Thank you, everyone. See you later. See you soon. Thank you.